Well, welcome back, my friends all, to another rousing rendition of Choir Boys Outdoors. This is the DRENGNR 5. It was designed by John Nelson Griffith. It was made by Shaney at Shade Indonesia. I'm going to do my dead level best to put John's information in the description, and I'm going to tag Shaney, so if you want to get a hold of him, you can. John tried to comment on the last video I did on this, and YouTube just wouldn't have it, so I'll do my best to put up with you. Listen, I have no idea what I'm titling this video. We're going to do the video. We're going to do it like this. We hadn't done one like this in a while, so we're going to check it out, and then we'll come up with a title together. Here's the deal, guys. It's got deep fullers, thick-ass blade stock, micarta handle scales, fits amazing in hand. Look at that pommel. I've already done one video on it, wasn't a use video. Let's see how far we can get. Can y'all see from there? Let me show y'all something. It's just folded. We'll put another crease in it. Let's see how sharp it is. Now, a lot of times when I do this, for you it's fake, yeah, and you're a dumbass. One of those two statements is true. All right, so it started off good. Look at that. Ooh. What happens, guys? Let me stop here. I'm going to stop here. What happens, guys, is the paper, I live in Florida, so you see it got off track there. The paper gets weak at the bottom. Damn thing, sharp as a razor. And here's the thing about Shaney. I am convinced more and more and more and more that Shaney's just a bad man. A dude can make it, and I mean that in a good way. Dude can make a knife. So here's what we're going to do. The DRENGNR 5 by John Nelson Griffith and Shaney from Shade Indonesia. Let's go outside. Let's do the do. Before we do, let's talk about this pommel. All right, look, again, if I want to stab here. Now, John Nelson Griffith is a fighter, an MMA guy, has a history in combat sports and self-defense. To me, this thing is set up for use in mind. A knife's a tool. People say, oh, it's a weapon. It's a tool. If I got to stab somebody, well, then that was the right tool for the job. That's my philosophy. Now, listen, I don't do a lot of videos like this, and this is why. It's going to be a long-ass video. It's the new year. What the hell else you got to do? Let's go cut some shit up. Look at that. You didn't even... And we're back. My bad. Tech lock sheath. You can carry it. Scout carry. Now, do I carry knives like that? Not a lot. But it is a great option, quick deployment. Honestly, on a knife like this, I would carry this on my left-hand side. I don't know why, but I like that coming up. Typically, if I carry Scout, I'm gonna carry it like this so that when I come up, the blade's out, point forward, bam, if I need it for that. If not, I'll turn my hand and pull it and have it correctly. I'll demonstrate. All right, guys, you can see right here how I got it when I pull. Is going to come. Now this is brand new, so the kydex is still pretty tight on it, which it should remain, but I'm gonna come with my edge out, and you can see the pommel there. I like pulling it that way. Now here's the deal. This is where it's gonna get. All right, guys, so that was the way that's if I was in some kind of self-defense situation, which I never am. And so normally what I would do, this on my left hand side, I just take my hand like this and pop it, and now I've got it, and that is pretty comfortable. So those are the two ways that you can deploy it. And again, I don't do scout carry a lot, but when I do, it's left-hand side. Now, again, and I say this a lot, but let me reiterate here. This zip tie test is really, I had a couple guys one time tell me, and hell, my son's one of them, they had a couple knives chip really, really bad cutting zip ties at work. Not all the time, but they appreciated me showing this test. And I thought, well, let's check it out, because I guess that could happen if it's a poor heat treat or a burn edge or something. You see right there, just go straight through it. Guys, we got our 2-inch ratchet strap here. I actually lucked up, man. I was getting gas the other day, and a truck driver was throwing this in a dumpster, and I stopped him. We have these at work, and I try to get all of them that are busted up, but there's only so many there that are busted up. And this dude, I said, hey, man, you throwing that away? And what, it was a stupid question. He just kind of looked at me. I said, can I have it? He goes, man, this thing mess up, man, I'll kill you. I said, that's what I want. So he was good enough to hand me something he was throwing in the dumpster. And it was busted up. But I'm like, hell, if it'll save me money or easier to find. And I like using these. I'm just going to show you. This one's old and it's beat up. But I want you to look at that. It's thicker than a seatbelt, right? And it's going to be a little tougher. I'd say it'd be a little tougher than most hides in North America, especially in the Southeast, okay? And so, guys, when I'm doing these videos, I'm going to do a video tonight by the fire. You don't see that down there? I'm going to build a campfire tonight and just kind of hang out and have a talk. We're wrapping up 2023, and let's go into 2024. And I want to cover a couple things. Why I do things, you know, my mindset on doing things, where we're moving forward, etc. Now, as far as this knife goes, I think everybody should have one. And the thing is this, we need a production run of this. It feels amazing in hand. One of the best handles, and I say that a lot, and I handle knives a lot, but I'm telling y'all, as God is my witness, for me, that's all I can speak to, for me, that this handle is perfection for me. And at the end of this video, I'm going to give you all the specs, the weight, the all that shit. But I'm just telling you, see how that, I mean, the transition with busted up hands, holding it this way. Look, let's go through it. Holding it that way. Holding it that way. There's no hot spots. Nothing jumps out to me. Now, a different hand may be different. This is knife bliss, man. And it's sharp as shit. Let me tell you something. You get a knife from Shaney at Shade, that son of a bitch is going to be sharp. God, I love this knife. The DRENGNR 5. We open with a little bit of stabbing just on that mat. That's a tractor trailer mat. This is just a piece of old tire tread. It's not steel belted or anything. The pommel makes this thing just a phenomenal, phenomenal stabber. I love it. Feels good in hand. Now, give you a look at the tip there. Give you another look at the edge. For me, it's comfortable either way, but I believe for me, I like this a little better. Perfect hand position. Straight through it. Next time I see some tire tread on the road, I got to get that shit. And you'll notice too, guys, we don't go out, I don't go all psycho stabbing. There's no need. It don't take a lot of force to stab something. Sharpness on display again. There it is. And we're just kind of doing that accordion style cut, which is good until the end, and then I look like an asshole because it's trying, it's like, come on man, wrap this thing up. Go right here. The thing, guys, is this, the comfort in hand is insane. I was hesitant to do a video in this style because I knew it'd take longer, but at the same time, I don't want to hurt myself. At the same time, a knife like this, taking a little extra time with it is a joy. Just gonna be honest with you. Go straight down. Now again, the reinforced sandblast hose, if you've ever messed with it, you know that shit. One, it's thick, tough, and it's reinforced. So just a different cutting medium there, but I enjoy cutting it. Let's see if we can do it without cutting ourselves. There we go. Ratchet strap. Nothing to it. We'll come all the way down again. Well, to the side, that a boy scab. Just like that. Great control with it too. I mean, that's the thing about this handle, and I might title it greatest handle I've ever used, because I'm gonna be honest with y'all, this thing is a dream, man. All right, let's do a little toughness stuff and see what we got here. Here's a piece of that. This is that old box store shit. something with little knots in it. There we go. Now, my guy John over at Heavy Set Tactical, shout out to him. I sent him that little angel from Shaney, so be checking him out too. Shaney's a hell of a builder, man. Hell of a builder. And John, as far as a reviewer, Heavy Set Tactical, good dude. Love his reviews. He's honest. He's fair. What we like. That's why I trust him to send shit to him. Let's get some little curls. Oh, yeah. Special shout out to, man, Freedom Frog Gear. Frog Frog is a great member of this community. His father-in-law is having some major heart surgery next week. Now, I on my community page, posted a link to a post he did. I would really appreciate if y'all go to Freedom Frog's Gear. There's going to be a link in the description. Find his community post to his father-in-law. Especially some of you guys who had some of these procedures or family, would, and just send some words of encouragement. Frog, we love you. Please tell your stepfather, man, we love him. I said father-in-law, that's not right. It's stepfather Peter, I'm sorry. Y'all let Pete know that we're thinking about him as a community. Let Frog know we're thinking about him. And so I don't get it confused. Let me just stop for a minute. Freedom Frog Gear, his stepdad, is having open heart surgery. Go to his page, his community page, and just leave some well wishes for his stepdad. Tell him Scab sent you. I know what they're going through. My dad's surgery is, and daddy's surgery is next week. So that's two big events. And I know both families would appreciate your support. Well, listen, guys, here's what we're going to do. I know it's a longer video. It's all right. We're going to cut now. I'm going to go back to narration for like 2 minutes to give you the size and the specs and show you a little more work. All right, DRENGNR 5. Let's keep. Well, thank you, Scab. Well, guys, let me give you the specs of the knife, and we'll do our causes before we wrap it up. The overall length on the DRENGNR 5 is 9. It looks like 9 5/8 inches. So that's the overall length. The blade length's 5 inches with about a 4 3/4 inch cutting edge. The handle, the overall handle length is like 4 4 7/8. But the inner grip, which is the most important part to me, is 4 1/2. That just says it all. That'll cover every hand in the world. Guys, I love this thing. If you can't tell by this video, man, it is an absolute dream. The blade stock is 3/16 thick, so it is light. It is fast. It's got 2 deep fullers, a lanyard hole right above the handle. That's for the quick flick chopping if you need to do that. The thing is this, oh, and it's made out of, it's Bohler K110, okay? So it's a form of D2, and Shaney's heat treat is just absolutely ridiculously good. That being said, guys, I got to do this part. There was a time in this country where 22 vets a day took their own lives. Now, the real number is between 15 and 29. We know that. We know that because we look it up every day. That's why here on this channel, we focus on the number 0. Anything over 0 is simply unacceptable. Vets, we love you. Man, you have a place here. Now, guys, I back the blue. I make no bones about that. I'm not going to argue with you over it. These are my causes and things that I believe in, and I also don't believe in arguing about it. I have my reasons. Believe me when I tell you that. Finally, if you are an addict, never quit quitting. Well, final thoughts, guys. Dude, the DRENGNR 5, we got to find a production run somewhere. It's just straight up badassery, son. Listen, going to have a fireside chat tonight. I love y'all. I'm Scab. You're not. The DRENGNR 5. I'm gone, son.